Hello, everybody. This is episode 4 of Auto Disruptor, and I've got a visitor. So, welcome to episode 4, Auto Disruptor, Digital Dealer Exclusive. Today is a very exciting day for me because I do have a wonderful visitor. Glenn, I want you to go ahead and introduce yourself, and then I'll tell them what we're going to talk about today.
Yeah, sure, Josh. Well, I'll be glad to. My name is Glenn Lundy. I am the General Sales Manager at the Dan Cummins Chevrolet and Buick in Paris, Kentucky, and I'm happy to be here.
Awesome. I wanted to talk about dealership culture, because I think it's a huge thing that you and I both started in 2011, and I think we both can say that the culture here has been one of the main things or reasons why we've been so successful. And I think if dealers out there want to, I'm not gonna say mimic us, but if dealerships want to move towards a better customer experience, I think that the culture and how they treat their employees is very important. And so what's your kind of take on that?
Well, I mean, it's real simple to me. It's pretty simple math. If I have miserable, unhappy employees, then I'm probably going to have miserable, unhappy customers.
Yeah.
That's just kind of how it goes. So there was a great speaker, hopefully I'll meet him one day, a guy named Simon Sinek, and he talked about looking at your business in the exact opposite way that most businesses look at, and figuring out why you do what you do, and taking care of your people, giving your customers a great experience, and ultimately your bottom line is going to be where you want it to be. So I've tried to develop that here with these guys.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to look at everything from my employees' perspective first, creating a culture where they know that they can achieve their dreams, they can reach whatever goals they want to reach. You know, we try to promote from within, just grow everybody from within, and in turn, all the employees here are phenomenal,
yeah.
And they treat our customers phenomenally, which has in turn led to the growth that we have made.
Yeah, I think it's been a huge thing because I started out as a salesman, just as you did.
Yep.
And moving up in the ranks and knowing what the culture we wanted from the owners, because the owners definitely put this perspective in our heads somewhat.
Oh yeah.
And I think they kind of pushed us towards what their ideas were, and then we kind of took over there. And I think with employees, I think the biggest thing, and we both have worked for those dealerships that you go through the meeting and it's they belittle you. The F bomb.
Oh, they'll kick your teeth in.
Yes, and then they say, "Okay, now go out there and sell cars." And I think the biggest thing is that we don't do that, and you know we don't go through the whole BS of actually beating our people up, because there's not any, no one's going to get anywhere if you beat them up.
Right.
You know, you can't tell them to go out and sell cars and they feel like crap. And I think that's been the biggest culture shift that we have encountered as an industry to change that. Because I think our employees are very important. I think, you know, I run the BDC, he runs the sales department. And I think with, you know, with my group of 9 right now, having little 5-minute meetings with them to learn what is important to them and their success. And then when you find out that they want to be your second, your end, your right hand man, and talking to them and develop them there, you actually deliver that.
Execute
that. Right. And I think that's what brings them along, and knowing that you are just as invested in their success as they are. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a huge thing on what dealers can do to change what they do.
Okay.
I mean, what do you think is the biggest thing for people to take from this video? What do you think is the biggest thing that they can take to execute on making their culture better?
There is this great speaker by the name of Zig Ziglar. Don't know if you've heard of him.
Zig's good.
But Zig Ziglar once said, the easiest way for me to achieve my goals is to help others achieve theirs. Mm-hmm. So the one biggest thing that I would want dealers to take out of this is whatever the goal is, you know, whether it be a volume goal or a gross goal or an experience goal, whatever it is, if you don't know the goals of your employees and what they're trying to achieve, and you're not on the road, if they're not on the road to success, you know, then you're just never going to get there.
Yeah.
Plain and simple. You can never achieve it. If you're focused on your individual goals, you will never reach them.
Yeah.
It is just fact, because there's so many people involved in this environment.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody from, you know, your detail crew to your body shop crew to your receptionist who answers the phone. You know, you've got your BDC, you've got your service, you've got your sales. There's so many moving
the list
parts.
Goes on and on.
You know, your title people. I mean, there's so many moving parts to every single car deal. And if all the people that are in that chain aren't growing, thriving, learning, and don't feel like they're part of a team, you can never, ever accomplish anything near, you know, what you want to.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think that a lot of dealerships kind of go just with the sales side and forget about all the other parts. If you forget detail, you come up with a dirty car. If your title work doesn't get processed correctly, you have all kinds of issues that go down that path. And so having everybody on that same path is crucial for a dealership to be successful in today's environment, because let's be honest, it's all the little things that add up. It's not, you don't have to do something that's this huge, impressive thing. Just doing what you say you're gonna do for your employees and for your customers changes everything.
Absolutely.
And I think a lot of dealerships have missed that point during this time of growth as an industry. And that's why a lot of dealerships have pulled so far ahead of dealerships that are not doing it.
Sure.
And the room for error is small now. It's small now, and I think a lot of dealerships have to get on point with that.
Well, I think back in the day, especially, which you can say that now by the internet.
Yeah.
But, you know, back in the day when I used to, you know, fax over credit apps to try to get approvals and, you know, all that stuff, everyone was competing with those in their market.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody was competing locally with other dealers locally. Now I'm competing with dealers in Ohio, Tennessee, West Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, California, Texas. I'm competing with everybody. It's just the power of the internet.
Yeah.
So it's a whole new ball game. We have to have happy employees. We have to have happy customers, because if you don't, your customers are going to rag on you online. Your employees are going to rag on you online.
Yes.
And everybody's going to hear about it, because when we go shopping for a car nowadays, that's where we go.
Mm-hmm.
We go online. We don't look within 2 miles of our house.
No,
we don't look within 10 miles of our house. We look 100 miles from our house, 200 miles from our house. So the competition level has completely changed the game. I think that the easiest and simplest way to attack that is to basically take a customer point of view and say, and a salesman's point of view or an employee's point of view, and say, what do most employees and most customers hate about the car business? What do they hate about it? Write it out, map it down. Okay, they hate all these things, and then figure out how to eliminate all that from your dealership. Plain and simple. If they hate the long wait, if they hate the back and forth, if they hate that you won't give them information, if they hate that they have to work bell to bell 7 days a week, if they hate that the compensation's not good, anything that they hate, you got to change it, man.
Mm-hmm.
You got to change it, because we're in competition with everyone now.
Yeah.
Everyone in the nation.
Oh, yeah.
Not just the guy down the street. So culture is key. Absolute key. Good employees, great experience for your customers equals great profits, great rewards.
Thank you very much. Obviously, I want to thank Glenn for being a part of this. If you need anything from me, you can obviously email me at autodisruptor@gmail.com, or you can obviously call me at 859-421-9377. What's your Twitter?
Oh, I don't know.
I'll figure it out and I'll put it up here. All right?
Twitter.
Thanks for watching. Bye.